On the go. praise indeed, and that's what we're here tonight to do. We have our garments of praise on, and we are going to praise your name. And here we go with our next song. It's called Hear Our Praise.
Be filled with joy.
with us, and I hope you're all safe and well at home, and I hope you're spreading the good word and letting people know about our service, and I hope they're watching as well from home. Any announcements I have tonight is, of course, we are here for the next couple weeks, probably until June, doing these for you, and so we'll see how that goes. The Brat Supper is going to be June 7th or June 27th. So keep that in mind and put that on your calendar. June 27th, after that football service, we will have our Brat Supper. Also, we're having if you have a graduate, junior high school, college, medical school, vet, wherever, if they're graduating this year, we're asking people to send in pictures of their graduate, and we're going to try to get them up on the screen or video next week, so the 16th of May. So if you get them into the church office, we'd appreciate that. We'll try to do that. I think that's all the announcements I have this evening, so we'll continue with our next song, and it's called Before You.
Pour on me your mercy.
We'll continue with our next song. It's called We All Bow Down.
Princes and paupers, sons and daughters, kneel at the throne of grace. Losers and winners, saints and sinners, one day will see his face.
nice song this evening. It's one we played before here, and it's a good song because you always lead by example, and this song will remind us that we are examples, and we need to watch what we're doing as an example. And we'll do that song right after we do the scripture lesson. The scripture here is 1 Peter 2, chapter 2, verse 9. You want to read along, please? But you are a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, God's own people, in order that you may proclaim the mighty acts of Him who called you out of the darkness and into His marvelous light. Scripture lesson this evening. And I will do our next song this evening, and like I say, it's you have to be an example. This is a good one. So it's called Slow Fade.
Thank you.
listening to tonight here is from Matthew Wesson. It's called Truth Be Told. Last week, Arlen Thompson passed away last week, in case you haven't heard that. That was late last week, so it didn't make it on the screen last week, but we want to bring that up this week, and please keep the Thompson family in your prayers. Also, the only other one I have, I know Cheryl Olson will be going in for knee surgery on Monday, so keep the Olsons in your prayers, especially with everything that's going on with the coronavirus and stuff, so just be mindful of that, and we wish Cheryl well for that, and we'll keep her in our prayers as well. So if you have anybody at home or you know that has a concern or you have a concern about them, please lift them up tonight. And if you have any joys, lift them up as well. And if you know a joyful thing, then share with the neighbors. It's always good to share your joys. So I'll say a short prayer together, and then we'll say our Lord's Prayer together. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this glorious day and being able to share your word with people all over the country and around the world if they happen to come up on our service, Lord. Be with those we lifted up here tonight. Be with them. Let them feel your gentle touch, Lord, and let them know you're there with them. Let all their friends know that they are there with them as well and by their side. Even if they can't be, they can send a card or a letter or whatever thing. They can give a call or text. So let them know that they are well and they are loved and that you are caring for them. So we pray all this in the name of your Son, Jesus the Christ, who taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. And it's a pleasure tonight. We have another guest speaker who will give us a message, and it's a pleasure to introduce Lane Vandermeyer.
First of all, I wish you all very much at Mercy Methodist Church and our Saturday night service, but thank you to Rick and Darlene and Denise for providing this each and every Saturday night, and it's a pleasure that they've asked me to speak today, and we'll go forward with this. But one other thing I'd like to announce, my mother and father and myself got the brats. You want to go get the brats. As support St. Jude's. Rick and Darlene make unbelievable cheese brats, so go for it. You know what? I always start off with the same prayer because I never want to believe any of these messages are about me, but they are about the good Lord. So let's give this message to the Lord in prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you that you and your Holy Spirit have given me the words to speak through my lips. May my flesh not come through my mouth today, dear. Dear Father, may this message honor you, worship you, praise you, and glorify you today, dear Heavenly Father. Dear Heavenly Father, may I have an open heart, and everyone that's hearing this message have an open heart to receive from this message. May I have an open mind, and everyone that hears this message today, tonight, is, Lord, receive it in their minds. And Lord, most of all, may it change me and change everyone. Your truth and promises never fail, and you are a good, good Father. In Jesus Christ's name, amen. We give the Lord credit on that. Mother's Day is tomorrow. Amen. Mothers are very important. And I'm going to do a message tonight called A Mother's True Love. Now, I love Rick's one verses, but tonight we're going to go a little bit deeper because this is a very sobering, sad scripture that turns into something beautiful. We're going to go all the way back to 1 Kings, and we're going to do 12 verses, because I cannot cut the story short for a mother's true love. 1 Kings 3, 16 through 28, if you are following me at home. 1 Kings 3, 16 through 28, if you are following. I'm doing it from the New Living Translation. Here we go. Sometime later, two prostitutes came to the king to have an argument. Please, my lord, one of them began, this woman and I lived in the same house. I give birth to a baby while she was with me in the house. 3 days later, this woman also had a baby. We were alone. There were only two of us in the house. But her baby died during the night when she rolled over on it. Then she got up in the middle of the night and took my son from beside me while I was asleep. She laid her dead child in my arms and took mine to sleep beside her. And in the morning when I tried to nurse my son, he was dead. But when I looked more closely in the morning light, I saw that it wasn't my son at all. Then the other woman interrupted. It certainly was your son, and the living child is mine. No, the first woman said. The living child is mine, and the dead one is yours. And so they argued back and forth before the king. Then the king said, let's get the facts straight. Both of you claim the living child is yours, and each says the dead one belongs to the other. All right, bring me a sword. And so a sword was brought to the king. Then he said, cut the living child in two, give half to one woman and half to the other woman. Then the woman who was the real mother of the living child and who loved him very much cried out, oh no, my lord, give her the child. Please do not kill him. But the other woman said, all right, he will neither be yours nor mine. Divide him between us. Then the king said, do not kill the child, but give him to the woman who wants him to live, for she is the mother. When all Israel heard the king's decision, the people were in awe of the king, for they saw the wisdom God had given him for rendering justice. A mother is closest to her child than anyone else, because mothers, you start out by carrying the child for 9 months in your womb. And that begins a bondness with your child from the day of conception. Mothers, for 9 months, you feel every movement of your child makes. Before anyone sees your child, this is a special bond that causes a mother to love her child from the very beginning and brings a mother's true love between the mother and the child. In the Word of God, there's an example of a mother and a child in the womb, and how close a mother and a child become. When the child is in the womb, we are going to look at Mary visiting Elizabeth in Luke 1, 39 through 45. A few days later, Mary hurried into the country of Judea, to the town where Zechariah lived. She entered the home and greeted Elizabeth. And at the sound of Mary's greeting, I want you to get this part, Elizabeth's child lived within her, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit. Elizabeth gave a glad cry and exclaimed to Mary, God has blessed you above all women, and your child is blessed. Why am I so honored the mother of my Lord should visit me? When I heard your greeting, the baby in my womb jumped for joy. You are blessed because you believe that the Lord would do what he said. You see, Elizabeth felt her baby in the womb jump for joy. What a beautiful example in the scriptures of how a mother and a child can become so close, and the mother can love her children with true love. Because of a mother's true love, I should say, for her children, many times a mother is in pain. A mother is in anguish and despair. When a child becomes ill, a mother's in pain. When a child is suffering pain, a mother feels pain. When a child is dying, a mother feels pain. When a child feels at anything in life, a mother feels pain. A child loses at a sporting event, a contest, or a chance for a job or a promotion, a mother feels the pain. A child is sad, depressed, hurt, or in despair, The child mother feels the pain. A child does something wrong and causes pain in his own life or her life. The mother feels the pain. A child cuts all relationships with her, and the mother feels the pain. All these events in a child's life can cause a mother so much pain, so much hurt, so much anguish, so much sadness, and so much despair. You want to know why? Because of her true love for her children. So, mothers, you understand the scripture of the Book of Kings better than anyone. I don't understand it because I've never carried a baby. I never will. In 1 Kings 23:3-25, the king said, "Bring me a sword." So they brought a sword for the king. He gave them an order and cut the living child in two and gave half to one and half to the other. And in the other verse, after the order, King Solomon, we see in verse 26 how a true mother of love acts towards her children, and how a woman acts when she is not the mother. In 3:26, it says, "The woman whose son was alive was filled with" what? "Compassion for her son, and said to the king, 'Please, my lord, give her the living baby. Do not kill him.' But the other said, 'Neither I nor you shall have him.'" Cut him in two. On Mother's Day tomorrow, we honor our mothers. We, you know what? Mothers, you have true compassion towards your children. Their love towards your children is so strong that you would protect them. You would protect your children from even death by giving them up. That is what you call true love towards anything, especially your children. Today, as I wrap this up, I am going to give you 10 ways to honor your mother. Not just tonight, not just tomorrow, but the rest of your life. As everybody knows, my mother is my best friend, and she stood by me through so many problems, health issues, financial issues, so many things. And I have to remember to do these 10 things to honor my mother today, tomorrow on Mother's Day, and the rest of my life. Number one, we need to forgive our mothers. No mother is perfect. And each mother has made mistakes. And we can best honor our mothers by forgiving them. Number two, speak well of your mothers. Another way we can honor our mothers is to speak well of our mothers and refuse to speak evil of our mothers. This one I love, one of my favorites. Number three, esteem your mother publicly and privately. Do you realize how important it is to give your mother credit when you can, in private and in public? They say they don't want it, but they really do love it. Number four, oh, this is for me, seek their wisdom. We honor a mother's wisdom when we seek their wisdom through life's twists and turns. Number five, support our mothers. We can honor our mothers by supporting them through forms of love and care. Number six, I never thought of this until I read this. Provide for our mothers financially. You know, they provided you when you had nothing. Now you may have a good job. Maybe you have found wealth. Maybe it's time to help your mother back out financially. Number seven, I love this one. Spend time with your mother on her agenda. Not when you can spend time with it, but when she's available. And spend time, you know what? And you know what? Have her pick out the time. It's not about you, it's about spending time with your mother. Number eight, another way to honor your mother. When was the last time you wrote a handwritten letter to your mother to tell you how much you appreciate her? To tell you how much she loved her? We don't write handwritten letters anymore, do we? said. Number nine, another way to honor your mother is never underestimate saying, "I love you." I'm going to repeat that. That's so powerful. It's so easy that we don't do it. Another way to honor your mother is to never underestimate saying, "I love you." And finally, a great way to honor your mother, why do you wait to write a tribute about your mother when she's already gone and passed away? Maybe you would like to honor your mother by writing a tribute and presenting it to her while she's still alive. I don't know if you had a good mother. I don't know if it was a bad mother. But there's been a woman in your life that acted like a mother. Everyone I've talked to has. And today, as we honor Mother's Day, we thank God for our mothers. We do. Mothers are very, very important. They will stand by with you. They will love you when everybody else gives up on you. Most of the time, our mothers are always there. And we thank God for our mothers on this Mother's Day. You know what? I just felt the Holy Spirit say, we're going to pray for our mothers a real short prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for the mothers you provided us. May we love them like you love them. May we care for them like you care for them. May we take care of them, may we do anything you want us to do for our mothers. We are so grateful that you provided us such wonderful women as our mothers on this Mother's Day. May we stop and not just recognize them tomorrow on Mother's Day, but recognize them and how much we love them and care for them and appreciate them every day of our life. In Jesus Christ's name, amen. Again, thank you for letting me up here today. May you all keep safe and enjoy my life.
Thank you, Lane, for that excellent message. And we truly do hope that all you mothers listening tonight, wherever you are, whether you're at your home, office, work, around the world, wherever you are, we're hoping that all mothers have a very good and blessed Mother's Day. We'll continue on the next song this evening. It's called Let the River Flow.
Thank you.
evening is by Michael W. Smith, and it's called Grace. We pray all this in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.